he actually, he did a great job pronouncing my name, and it's kind of, it's a different song. It's Ocean Gal. And when I was a little kid growing up, you know, first day of school would always be a really tough day for me because it was roll call day. So that's when the teacher's like supposed to pronounce like who's in the class. So then the teachers will like start to go through, and they're like, oh, okay, is Chris here? Okay, present. Is Jeff here? Okay, and all of a sudden the patients start doing this. And then I'm like looking around, I'm like, I know I have a different sign name, but I hope it's not me. And then all of a sudden she finally blurted out something. She goes, is Cash in here? And so like, I don't want to be rude, so I might be a little Cash in or something. So, and, but then all of a sudden she says it again, and it's like, no, man, it's coaching. And without a beat, she says, are you sure? I'm like, listen, I know I'm a little kid, I'm not fucking retarded. I'm not fucking retarded. And I thought to myself, like, if I was going to try to fool you, don't you think I would have done a better name than Koshin? I would have done something like this, a Super Bowl all over again. Is Billy here? Okay, is Jeff here? Is Prince in the Revolution here? That's how it feels like in Dust Pride. I'm really a huge fan of names, and particularly I like Asian names, so I don't know if there are any Asian people in the audience. No? It's okay, you're here with us. but one of the really interesting things they do is, like, I met this one guy, and he's like, yeah, my name is M.O. Lee, but you can call me Mike. So I looked at him, and I went, why? And he explained to me, he goes, like, we have, like, our Asian name and our American name. And I was like, that sucks. I like M.O. Lee better. It's, like, more difference. It's a beautiful sounding name. That would be, like, an African guy, like, introducing himself to me, and I'd be like, hi, my name is... Hey, you can call me Kevin. I look on the internet. I guess we all do. So this is something I came across recently. I was looking up animal sexuality for some reason. I came across this. Apparently, the seahorse. Right, you guys know what seahorses are, the whole thing is in the, it's like a monkey shit. apparently they're known for being like very monogamous and they stay together for life. Apparently that's all bullshit because some researcher found out that this is actually the wording. He goes, seahorses may be graceful and elegant, but the idea that they are monogamous and made for life is just a myth. According to an actual study, the sea creatures are promiscuous, flighty, and more than a little bit gay. I know that was a little bit off, but what's really interesting is it goes on, and this is a side note it puts on, but it goes, none more so than the Australian seahorse. Like, are like the French seahorses, like, looking around going like, maybe it. Look at those faggots. So gay. Let's just go back to Graves and listen to Elton John. So another weird thing I recently found out is when I get scared and Donald's against me, when I get scared, for some reason my natural reaction is to take my pants off. So and I realized, and someone was like, "Oh, I guess you're scared of pants," or but. And I'm not proud of that because it's very awkward. It's, you know, it's a very big deal because, you know, like, I'm watching a scary movie with my grandma and it becomes very awkward. I have a lot of white friends and I'm not bragging. they're white, whatever. But one of the things they like to do a lot of times, they'll be like, oh, you know, you're acting white or something. They'll say that to me and I'm like, why would you say that? And they're like, oh, well, you listen to rock music. Okay, fair enough. I like to read books. then the last time I thought it was really funny, like, oh, and you know, you like black girls. I'm like, hey. And like, then I realized that he put me on the site, like, stuff like people like. I'm like, oh, those are three things on that site, so I guess they're right. I don't know, I recently, I watched Forrest Gump. I hadn't seen that movie in a long time. I like that movie. It's very touching. But something I didn't realize the first time around stress, but so I'm gonna end this on a happy note. There's a give you know high fives are a big sign of friendship, right? Well, apparently there's an appropriate time and place when you're supposed to do that. It turns out coming out of your best friend's closet after you found out on a hot chick, not the appropriate time. Alright, thank you guys. You've been very
Let's go, team!